Propeller effects can be seen as the side effects experienced as a direct or indirect result of an engine spinning a propeller. Newton's third law states that for every action there's an equal and opposite reaction. So the equal and opposite reaction of a propeller spinning in one direction is the rest of the airplane trying to spin in the opposite direction. Viewed from the position of the pilot, most engines spin propellers in a clockwise direction, and thus the rest of the airplane will want to spin in an anti-clockwise direction or bank to the left. This is called the torque effect and is the first of four left-turning tendencies a propeller airplane experiences. This effect is lessened in flight by the wings, which will provide resistance to the spinning force. And the faster an airplane flies through the air, the more resistance the wings will provide against the tendency to bank to the left due to the propeller torque effect. The opposite is also true, and the slower an airplane flies, the more pronounced the propeller torque effect will be. The strength of the torque effect also increases as engine power increases. At full engine power accelerating for takeoff, the wheels on the runway prevent the plane from banking left. But as soon as the wheels leave the runway, due to low airspeed over the wings and high power produced by the engine, it results in the torque effect being very noticeable at this stage, but lessens as the airplane picks up airspeed. The second effect of a spinning propeller is called spiraling slipstream. As a propeller spins, it doesn't just push air back in a straight line, but swirls it, and you can almost think of it as a mini horizontal tornado. And the air will swirl around the fuselage in the same direction as the propeller. This is visually apparent when propeller tip vortices form, which beautifully shows the spiraling slipstream. As the wind moves further backwards, swirling around the fuselage in the same direction as the propeller, the air will impact the vertical stabilizer on the left side. This pushes the tail of the airplane to the right, and thus the nose of the airplane to the left. Or in aviation terms, it yaws the airplane to the left, and it is thus the second of the four left-turning tendencies. The third propeller effect is called gyroscopic precession. Since a propeller is mass that spins, it acts like a gyroscope. Fully explaining this could almost make up a dedicated video. But in short, a spinning gyroscope will keep pointing to a fixed point in space as long as it doesn't lose rotational speed. The force with which a spinning gyro will attempt to keep pointing to a fixed point in space is stronger the heavier the spinning gyro and stronger the faster it spins. But even though a spinning gyro will attempt to keep pointing to a fixed point in space, its inertia isn't infinitely strong, and applying a torque to it has an interesting but predictable result, which is called precession. If a torque is applied on a spinning gyro, it will tilt the gyro in the same direction as the initial torque, but at a point 90 degrees of rotation later. For example, if a torque is enacted in this direction at the bottom of this spinning gyro, the resulting torque is affected 90 degrees of rotation later, which is here, and the gyro will thus tilt in this direction. Applying that to a propeller airplane, from the pilot position, the propeller spins in a clockwise direction. The result of a tail dragger starting the takeoff roll and lifting the tail is in effect a torque applied forward at the top of a spinning gyro. 90 degrees later is in this position, and applying the torque in the same direction, yes, you guessed it, it will yaw the plane to the left, and the gyroscopic precession is thus the third left turning tendency. Keep in mind that precession is stronger the more torque is applied. This is one of the reasons why pilots should always slowly lift the tail of a tail dragger on the takeoff roll, as a quick push forward will yaw the plane to the left with a lot more force. Related to this, an interesting phenomenon I almost never hear pilots talking about is the right turning tendency. This is experienced on a nose wheel airplane when it rotates. Since in effect it is a forwards torque enacted on the bottom of the gyro, which is the spinning propeller, 90 degrees later is at this position, and the forwards torque here will result in the airplane yawing to the right. But you will be forgiven if you're a pilot and you've never quite experienced this right turning tendency, as it won't always be that apparent to the pilot. But why is that? On a tail dragger lifting the tail, the left turning tendency is very noticeable. So why isn't the right turning tendency that noticeable on a nosewheel airplane when rotating? Well, simply because a nosewheel airplane having just rotated for takeoff have induced the fourth propeller effect, and one that causes a left turning tendency, and it would often mask and overpower the right turning tendency. It's called P factor and is experienced on a tail dragger on the takeoff roll with the tail still down. As soon as the tail goes up to horizontal, P factor completely disappears. A nosewheel airplane will also experience this once the nosewheel comes up and traveling along the runway. So, what is P factor? P factor is only experienced when a propeller doesn't hit oncoming air perpendicularly. For example, a tail dragger accelerating on the runway has its propeller tilted backwards, and the propeller does not hit oncoming air perpendicularly, but at an angle. The plane in this example will thus experience P factor. P factor is also known as the asymmetric blade effect, and to understand it, we need to look at the angle of attack of the propeller blades as it goes through the horizontal, going up on one side and down on the other. It's all related to the angle of attack of the propeller blades. The angle of attack is the difference between the blade chord line and the relative wind. And for comparison, we'll use a speed for which the relative wind direction is like this. When an airplane is flying or moving in a nose-level attitude, the blade going down on the side of the plane we are looking from will have the same angle of attack as the blade when it gets to the horizontal on the other side of the plane. But when an airplane is moving in a nose-high attitude, like a tail dragger accelerating for takeoff on the runway with the tailwheel still down, the oncoming wind isn't perpendicular with the propeller blades. When the propeller blades is at the horizontal position on the side of the plane we are looking from, the blade's angle of attack is thus more than when the blade is at the horizontal on the other side of the plane. Looking from the pilot position, the blade when close to the 90 degree position on the right has more angle of attack than the blade when reaching the 90 degree position on the left. The blade's higher angle of attack on the right will thus create more thrust than at the left. In addition to the higher angle of attack of the downwards going blade, it also has a higher airspeed than the upwards going blade. Seeing as the propeller's plane of rotation is tilted, the downwards going blade has a small forward vector, and the upwards going blade has a small rearward vector. This makes the difference in thrust between the downward and upward blades even more. The thrust is thus asymmetric and results in a tendency to turn or yaw the plane to the left, and hence P factor is the fourth and final left turning tendency of a propeller aircraft. Naturally, the higher the attitude of the nose, the more the difference in thrust between the two sides and the more extreme the left yawing tendency. And additionally, the higher the power setting, the more this left yawing tendency, and will thus be at its highest in the takeoff phase of flight, or any stage where a high power setting is used at low airspeed. The four mentioned propeller effects all stack up in different ways in slightly different phases of flight, but they are all most noticeable in the takeoff phase, and correcting this is usually given a lot of emphasis in flight training. And if you as a pilot feel that you don't quite experience all of the above mentioned tendencies, remember that propeller engines are usually mounted angled to the right for the very reason to oppose the left turning tendencies and lessen its effect. And rudder trim are usually to the right as well for the same reason. These countermeasures don't remove the left-turning tendencies, but opposes it to reduce its net effect. I previously published a video of the basic propeller concepts, and I promise to cover some more advanced propeller concepts in a part 2 video if there was enough interest, which there overwhelmingly was. I decided to dedicate this video only to propeller effects, since it doesn't really fit in with some of the more advanced concepts that I want to cover. So I decided to rather make a dedicated video covering those more advanced concepts. So do look out for that upcoming video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.